wanted to go over with you guys what happens when a miter joint goes wrong. And this happens a lot. It's really hard to get all these points spot on. Depending on what kind of tool you use, sometimes they're a little bit easier. In this case, I made this one skewed a little bit on purpose. With this glue up, there's three main issues. We have where this one on my right is just a little bit proud, where you can feel that popping up past this top piece. The other problem with it is we have a good gap all along there. The third problem that we have is this piece is proud of this, meaning right here on this beveled mitered edge, we have just a little bit of lip there. That really shows up a lot when we oil it. So I'm gonna walk you through three easy ways to take care of all of these without using putty or epoxy.
So choosing the right sliver is crucial. Instead of taking one that is cut with a grain, I'm gonna go ahead and take one that is cut cross grain. It's got a small bevel on it. It is a little bit fragile. This will really tie in that grain a lot better. Clean out that groove nicely just to make way for that sliver. Put some glue in there and wiggle that thing in the best you can. Now instead of breaking that thing off, I find it best to back cut it with the razor blade. That way it'll break off in a fairly nice straight line and it won't break off lower than you want it to. I always find it best to sand as soon as you can, just so all that wet glue takes that sawdust on nicely and covers up any imperfections. Typically working with an inside miter joint like this is really difficult to take down that proud surface to meet up perfectly with the other miter. So right here I'm gonna take a razor blade, which really gives me the control to shave away just as much as I want. And then from there I'm gonna take a piece of sandpaper and feather it back to where I want it to be.
As you can see, we tidied up this miter joint pretty good. Just by the use of slivers, some glue, sanding, but really the key is to meet these points perfectly, fill in any kind of gaps you have, and fill it in with, if you can, the same material, such as the walnut here. In the end, nobody would ever know that what happened so many times never happened this time.